There's a lot of stories that get told about like creation myths, right? Everybody's got a creation myth. So there's a lot that could have led to me being a musician, but mostly it was that I was a really noisy kid. When we moved here, we started renting this house. It came with a piano and a crazy, interesting attic. And one day I found this like really old poetry book. That and the piano were like two of the most significant things that happened to me growing up, I think. Anytime I had a problem or I was sad about something or needed to work something out, I would sit at the piano. The first time I came back was after living in Boston, and there I had learned how to swear really effectively and chain smoke. Don't smoke. Smoking feels bad. I think I'd picked up a kind of directness that I've not really lost. It was refreshing to live in a place where like people just say the thing. But when I came back pregnant with my son the second time, that was different. I left my career and my place in Seattle, and all right, I'm mom now, I don't. Okay, let's read every book about parenting that exists and get a part-time job. But what's funny is I had stopped playing music when I lived in Seattle because I was so obsessed with my job and good at it, and it took a lot of time. But to come back to Bellingham and to be pregnant, I actually realized like the value of music to my life, because all of a sudden I had all this time on my hands. And also I discovered that when I played guitar, the baby would kick. You were born against the sky, and it was like the culmination of getting this piano around that time and taking a poetry class at the same time and my son having an early bedtime, so that I had some time to myself. And one night I was like working on this poem for class and couldn't make it do the thing that I wanted it to do. And I realized that it wasn't a poem, it was a song. And you can convey all that interesting feeling in the melody. And it was having the piano that helped me transform this like medium bad poem into like the song Sleep, which is one of the first songs I ever wrote. Wish that I could sleep with open windows. In the last year and a half, my style has really radically changed because the feeling that I'm conveying now is anger. And it was so hard to reveal. Female anger is not a popular emotion to convey. Nostalgia, sadness and longing, those sort of things. Like those, I do those things and I've done those things. But like, people should know what it's like to be mad. And I want to create a musical community where other mad ladies can show up and be heard. You may wonder why I'm like this, why I never quit a fight, why I knock the doors. The feeling is not just explaining to someone why it is that you're angry and suspicious and why you can't tell someone to smile and all that shit. It's also every time you have to talk to somebody about something like that, a little bit of you has to relive the things that have made you the way that you are. I want people who have been through hardship like that to know they're not alone. You just can't not be political right now. How could you even not be political right now? I just, getting to sing for the Women's March was unreal. It was unbelievable. It was like, for all of its like faults and all the times that it lets everyone who's not a white dude down, this is my country too. Like, I get to be here. Everyone gets to be here. I didn't write my own music until I was like almost 30 years old because I was so worried about it being good. And now I know that the most important part of the creative process is just don't edit a goddamn thing. Just get all the stupid words, all the like cliches and all that shit. Just get the feeling down and then come back to it later to do the crafting and the editing, right? That's the good stuff. That's the nice thing about the art scene in Bellingham too, I think, is that we've all kind of reached the point where we're like, well, fuck, we're not doing this for money. So then what do we do this for? We do this for each other and for ourselves and for the community. And we just get it out there and we just keep making incredible art and we just keep doing it. And if you do it enough, it gets real good.